What does it look like?
But you did not touch the food I served you.
Which food?
Your food.
You have just proven that your brain is still very active. After so many years, as it was back in those days.
You can say that again, Igwe. This is the same old Missy Emeka that you know. Age has nothing to do with the ability of one to remember things.
Well, all you've just remembered, it's a proven testimony that I should uphold my principles. I shouldn't back down from them. So, all that needs to be done, have to be done before the offer.
Exactly, Igwe. This will offer us an undivided attention in the preparation of this offer. And you see, this is a good news, my boy. Now, talking about your father, what about the Crown Prince?
What about him?
Igwe, you know that your son cannot celebrate two of Allah as a single man. After his enthronement as a Crown Prince, he has to choose a bride whom he must present before the elders. The Council of Elders, rather, within 4 months before the fall.
Oh no, this is actually a big problem for me. I've been having a running battle with my son, the prince, for almost a year now because of this issue. He keeps rejecting all my choices of women for him. I mean, it appears his standards are way too high.
Igwe, it is not your duty to choose a bride for the prince. Because even your father, the late king, abolished the tradition that the king should not choose a bride for the crown prince. You should allow the prince to choose a bride for himself.
Look, Oni. This is not a question of tradition. I know my son very well. He is very hardworking. He's a wise young man. But when it comes to the issue of women, he lacks the capability to choose the right one. Because the kind of woman he needs is someone who can complement his good qualities. Okay, so I have gone through a whole lot of trouble trying to get a woman that is perfect to complement his good qualities. And I think the one he's dating right now is a perfect one to play that role.
Many seen one already.
Of course. He's seen one. She's the daughter of the secretary to the state government. You know, he has gotten the tickets for the next governorship election. He's to be our next governor.
I see. Then why the delay?
He should go ahead and act fast to avoid stories that touch.
Passport war, if you got one, you sobu every day. Kata kata,
when you're yellow to a big one. Are you not the one I've been calling since? I mean, you blind for ear? Yeah, Nebechi, please. I am not cut out for your troubles this month. Do you hear me? Please, just leave me alone. Oh? You are not cut out for my insobu this morning. Ngapugaka. No problem. Yeah? What was that charade you did at the market for?
It all depends on what you refer as charade. Do you know? I would advise you to go to that market and sort yourself out with those market people, and not me. You know, because they're putting you out also everywhere. Eh?
What thing?
Biko, na kwe mana osa soge ka unwe. Eh? Wanne, Biko. Eh? Biko. Biko. Like I said, I was actually going to your house before I met you here. Eh?
Chelo. Wait. Was this the reason you displayed like a mad person then?
Me, mad person. Both of us know who the mad and crazy one is. Muna gima no gibu onyala. Onyala yakwa.
Ngozi, what is it again? Is it not too early to make troubles? What is it this time?
I will not repeat myself. Chinwe, I will not repeat myself. Who cut my plantain this morning?
Your plantain?
You heard me.
Point of correction, my dear co-wife. That plantain belongs to everyone in this family. And if you must know, I needed to prepare plantain porridge for my husband, so I cut it. You can as well take from the bunch if you care.
Thunder will fire you, dear. Thunder fire you, dear Chinwe.
Ngozi.
After the disgrace you and your prodigal daughter gave to me yesterday, you still have the guts to go and cut my plantain. And you have the nerves to ask me to take from the bunch.
Yes. Because that plantain belongs to everyone, not only you.
Excuse me. I should excuse you.
Okay? Ngozi, excuse me.
If you know what is good for you, Chinwe, go to the market and buy that same plantain and come and replace it.
Says who?
Me, of course. The only legitimate wife in this house.
Okoha, my brother. I understand your anger. Eh? But please forgive me. Eh? Don't make it look as if I planned it. At least you can now see what your brother is going through in that house.
Huh? Ibe, my brother, it is not as if you planned it. I know you did not plan it, but thinking that an itchy like me will run the way I did like a child in a broad daylight saddens me. It saddens me, Ibe. What if that axe has landed on my head? Huh? What just if?
But the most important is, it did not. And please, Okoha, my brother, all I need now is how to stop those madness before it will take me to my early grave. What else can we do? The worst is that they cannot listen to anybody.
Exactly my point. Exactly my point, my brother. But we need to do something regardless. Because
you are right, my brother. After all, we have to do something.
Okay.
We will do something.
Because,
by the way, where are your wives?
They were in the house when I left the house. Yes.
Okay. Let us go to your house.
My way back from the market.
Hey! Have you seen it? Have you seen it now? I'm asking you. Have you seen it? Have you seen what you have brought this witch and my daughter to?
Who are you calling a witch?
You.
Me a witch?
Yes, you are a witch. You are a witch.
You are even lucky that your foolish daughter came back alive, Indiana. You are lucky that she came back alive.
Is it
and daughter, you see, God must step from you. Eh? I will strike you with this thing. In a parlor, what is your problem? And you too.
Me too. What did I do?
Why are you all silent? Why can't you speak now? Huh?
My wife, we really want to know where all these problems is coming from, so that we can solve it and put an end to this.
Nayokwa, there's no need asking all these questions. We all know that Ngozi is the problem here. She's the only one that touts and pick up fights with me at every opportunity, thereby creating the enmity between my daughter and her daughter. So you people should ask her what her problem is. Nene Adjone.
Ngozi, you heard what your co-wife said. What do you have to say?
Say what exactly? What do you want me to say? You people made me sit down here to listen to this thing with all the nonsense coming from my mouth. Okay?
Ngozi, my wife, calm down. We only want to find solution to all these problems so that peace can reign.
That's not peace. Peace, Ikwa. Where? Come. Excuse me, which peace are you even talking about? Is it the one that owns that chemist shop at the market square? Or the crippled one at the next village? Listen, let me tell everyone sitting down here right now. Eh? Hey! Not until this woman and her child leave this house. There's nothing like peace.
Mama!
Hey!
Mama now!
Will you keep quiet? Shut up! Is it Mama now? What are you doing?
Mama.
Listen, Mama, what are you shouting at?
You have seen it now.
Oh.
You have seen what the problem is already. You forgot it, yeah? You said it.
Fighting cannot solve this situation. If Nanya. Quarreling cannot save
you. Give a shame on you. Shame! Useless man!
How many months? Just few months into our marriage, you cannot take care of me. Even go and ask your mates what they do to take care of their wives. All you do is come back to the house with stories every day. You are just a useless man. Even you are so useless. Useless man! Shame on you! Ibe! Where are you going to? Ibe, where are you going to? Come back here, shameless man! Shame! Shame! It's only a useless man that fights and run away. Come back and meet your wife! You come back and meet me here. I don't even know how I ended up with this kind of a good for nothing man. Rubbish! You come back! You want me to die of hunger? Did I beg you to marry me? Did I beg you to marry me?
I'm sorry. I didn't see you. I'm sorry.
No problem. It's fine. But if I may ask, why are you always lost in thought anytime you're walking on the road? What is it?
Sorry, I don't understand.
Okay. The other day I saw you when a bicycle knocked you down because you were not looking. And now this. What is eating you up? What is it?
Please, I don't know what you're talking about. Please, excuse me.
Hey, wait. Sometimes, you might find a brother's shoulder in a total stranger to lean on. My shop is down the road. Feel free. Just come, let's talk. If you don't mind.
I have heard the story you just said to me, and I feel deeply sorry about your situations. But why would bad financial issues make a handsome and prospective man like you go through all this? People go through all this and still stand strong.
Yeah, I know. But the pressure from my people has become unbearable for me to handle. And the place I work, they are yet to reinstate me or pay me what I'm due.
I understand. I understand you perfectly, trust me. But what if the bicycle that hit you was a car and gave you a big injury? What are you going to do? Is it going to solve your problems or compound it? I thought as much.
You okay?
You'll be fine. You just have to calm down. I live in this compound as well. You're free to visit me anytime you want.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
You're always welcome. So, what can I offer you?
Thank you, I'm fine.
Are you sure? I hope you came back with good news.
Is that supposed to be a welcome?
Do you deserve a welcome? No, Ibe, answer me. Do you deserve a welcome? The money.
Ngozi, please, I don't have the time this afternoon.
Please, I don't have the time. I don't have
the time. Ibe, bring the money. Give me money, oh! Give me money! I've been hungry since money! Give me money!
Ngozi, leave the way, let me pass.
You're not entering this house.
Ngozi, leave the way, let me pass.
Ibe, this house will not contain... Ibe! This house will not contain both of us today.
What is wrong with you now? Ngozi, what's all this?
Give me money. I did not beg you to come and marry me. Okay. You cannot carry me all the way from my father's house and come and be maltreating me and be suffering me!
Okay,
give me money.
Eat me up now.
Okay.
Eat me up! What's the meaning of all this now? Ngozi, let me go. Let me go!
Ibe! Ibe, you're beating me up! Ibe is beating me up! Ibe is beating me up!
So tell me, how did it go with the railway corporation? Any luck?
Nope. They denied me audience as usual.
Too bad.
You know, that is how it has been for over 4 months now. And I'm forced to live with it.
That is bad. Yeah, I've been meaning to ask. Are you from this village?
No, I'm from the neighboring village. But I live close to the boundary. so my house is very close to this place. That reminds me, what about your parents and your siblings? You don't seem to talk about them at all.
My parents are late.
What?
Yes. They died in an automobile accident with my only brother 2 years ago. It's just me.
So sorry. Please accept my heartfelt sympathy.
It's fine. Thank you.
But you don't look like someone that has lost her family. How do you manage to be this strong?
Yeah, you're right. I've gone past it. Life goes on. I try to pick the pieces of my life and move on. But my uncle has been so supportive. But still, I still have to be strong.
True.
And, you know, move on with my life. And that is what I want you to do with your life.
As you can see, I'm better than yesterday.
I can see. Isn't it? Obviously.
I'm trying.
I'm happy that you're smiling today.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I have to stop here.
Okay.
You know I left my shop open.
Yes, that's true. You've really tried. Thank you for everything, my good friend. I really appreciate it.
You're always welcome. I think you have to go now. It's getting dark.
Yes, yes, yes. I'll check up on you anytime soon. Okay?
Alright. Yeah.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye. Yay. Useless man. I am still trying to understand why you called me out here by this hour of the night. What is it now? Eh?
But I have said everything now, haven't I?
You have said nothing. As far as I'm concerned, you have said absolutely nothing. So you want me to believe that you brought me all the way from my father's house? And just within how many months of marriage, you can no longer perform your duties and take care of me as you used to do? And you want me to understand that? Eh?
You just said, as I used to. That means I was doing my job as a husband. Not until I was unceremoniously dismissed from my workplace.
And so? Not until I was ceremoniously dismissed from my workplace all the time. And so? So I should live in the past and die of hunger? Is that what you're saying?
Ngozi, all I'm saying is that you should be patient. Everything will be fine. See, all I need from you now is your support at this difficult time. Okay, take for example now. For about 4 months now, 4 months, you have refused me to touch you. How are we supposed to stay together, live together as couple?
Hey, Ibe, now I see the main reason behind this meeting. Ibe, you are shameless. You are very shameless. Wait, oh. So you will shamelessly make love to me on an empty stomach? Eh? Ha! See, let me tell you something. You will not have the right to touch me until you start performing your duties as a man of the house. Good night.
Ngozi.
Igwe.
Where's my food?
There is no food.
Ngozi, your husband is not feeling fine. I went out there to get some drugs. Coming back now, you are eating the remaining food in the house. How do you expect me to take my drugs without eating?
Igwe, your wife has not eaten since how many years now? And you expect me to leave the remaining food in the house for you simply because you want to take medication? Only a selfish and a foolish man will think like that.
Because what's wrong with you now? What's wrong with you? Okay, how do you expect me to take these drugs now? What am I going to do now? The chemist warned that I should eat well before taking the pills. But how do I find something to eat now? I don't have any money on me. And my brother is not yet back since he traveled. I can't go borrowing either because I'm yet to pay back the ones I borrowed from people. I don't have money, so it could be worse if the sickness is deep into my body. I think I have to do it.
Ibe, what is wrong? Why are you like this? What's going on? Just hold on. Let me take you inside, okay? Just come.
Now that you've taken the drugs, I think you need to lie down and rest. That is, if you can.
Thank you, but I need to leave now. My...
Nothing will happen to you. Just rest. You can leave when you're much better. Come on, don't bite.
It's okay.
Is that yes? Okay, let me do this. Now,
much better.
Good to hear.
What's it by the time now?
It should be past 1 o'clock.
What? Please, I want to start going now.
Are you sure?
Yes. I need to go now.
Are you sure?
Yes.
But. Don't you think you need to rest a little?
No, I'm better now. I need to go now.
Okay, let me see you.
Okay, thank you.
Fighting cannot serve this situation. If I die. Quarreling cannot serve this situation. If I die. Your distance from people who we never underneath they are around, cause they will always try to make it feel like it's only your fault.